good now. I hope you are doing splendidly well on this fine and glorious now. Of course, your now is much different than my now, the now of when this video was recorded. However, for all intents and purposes, let's just pretend that you and I are sharing the same now, okay? So, in this video, I will be sampling for the very first time, which I'm not really sure if that's a good thing, some Marmite. I'm not sure if you ever heard of this, but there was someone that had suggested this, not tasting it, but just brought it to my attention, somewhat in a comical sense, not too serious, which I mentioned in one of my podcasts. However, I thought, you know what? Why not taste it and see what it's like? I may have heard of Marmite before. I'm not sure if you have or if you've ever eaten it or anything. I think I've heard of Vegemite. So we'll have to do another video like this featuring Vegemite. Okay, so if you are not familiar with this, we'll do a little brief knowledge sharing session right here. I have Wikipedia pulled up, so if you'd like to read along with me, you can. Wikipedia.org with the section for Marmite. Marmite is a food spread made from yeast extract invented by German scientist Justus von Liebig and originally made in the United Kingdom. It is a byproduct of beer brewing and is currently produced by British company Unilever. The product is notable as a vegan source of B vitamins, including supplemental vitamin B12. And apparently the original date of invention or inception is 1902. Marmite is a sticky, dark brown paste with a distinctive, salty, powerful flavor. This distinctive taste is represented in the marketing slogan, "Love it or hate it." Such is its prominence in British pop culture that the product's name is often used as a metaphor for something that is an acquired taste or tends to polarize opinion. Marmite is commonly used as a flavoring, as it is particularly rich in umami due to its very high levels of glutamate. And in case you're wondering what umami is, it's a word that I don't really use that often, rarely even see it. Umami is from the Japanese, and it's also known as savoriness, and is one of the five basic tastes. It has been described as savory and is characteristic of broths and cooked meats. Okay, so back to Marmite. The image on the jar shows a Marmite, a French term for a large covered earthenware or metal cooking pot. Marmite was originally supplied in earthenware pots, but since the 1920s has been sold in glass jars. Similar products include the Australian Vegemite, whose name is derived from that of Marmite, the Swiss Senovis, C-E-N-O-V-I-S, the Brazilian Cenovit or Cenovit, and the German vitamin R. Marmite has been manufactured in New Zealand since 1919 under license, but with a different recipe. How about that? That product is the only one sold as Marmite in Australasia and the Pacific, whereas elsewhere in the world, the European version predominates. Here's some different ways in which you can use Marmite. Marmite is traditionally eaten as a savory or umami spread on bread, toast, savory biscuits, or crackers, and other similar baked products. Owing to its concentrated taste, it is often spread thinly with butter or margarine. Marmite can also be made into a savory hot drink by adding 1 teaspoon to a mug of hot water, much like OXO and Bovril, which I've never had either one of those. Marmite is also commonly used to enrich casseroles and stews. Marmite is often paired with cheese, such as in a cheese sandwich, and has been used as an additional flavoring in mini cheddars, a cheese-flavored biscuit snack. And I would have liked to try Marmite with cheese on crackers, but I don't have any cheese or crackers. But we have Marmite, so all is not lost. And I'll be getting into what I'll be tasting or the Marmite with in just a little bit. Similarly, it is one of Walker's Crisps flavors and is sold as a flavoring on rice cakes and is available in the form of Marmite biscuits. Starbucks in the UK has a cheese and Marmite panini on its menu. Why can't we have that here in the United States? Marmite has been used as an ingredient in cocktails, including the Marmite cocktail and the Marmite Gold Rush. And I'm trying not to laugh. Well, I did this in a podcast, and again, it just hits me funny thinking of all the different cocktails, right? Drinks, liquors, and whatever, and then, you know, to go up to a bar and say, excuse me, I'd like to have the Marmite cocktail. Anyway, okay, so, and there we go. All right, so that's all the info on Marmite, and let me show you what I'll be sampling it with. I have, in lieu of not having any crackers, I do have graham crackers, which have been sitting in the cupboards for like months. I thought this would be maybe a cool way to try it. A little bit of salt and savory of the Marmite with the sweet crunch of, you know, salt and sweet kind of thing. I also have some buttered toast. Teapot, some hot water. So we'll, I guess we'll do this first. We'll open up the Marmite and we'll pour some hot water into a mug we'll see how that works out. All right, so what we have here, it says Marmite yeast extract, rich in B vitamins, a vegan spread. And let's see here, little symbol here of the Queen's crown, by appointment to Her Majesty the Queen, manufacturers of food and household products, Unilever, UK Limited, Leatherhead, Surrey, Leatherhead. That's interesting. Reminds me of Leatherface. Wake up your taste buds. Put the oomph in your breakfast. Yeast extract spread fortified with B vitamins. Ingredients: yeast extract, which contains barley, wheat, oats, and rye, salt, vegetable juice, concentrate, vitamins, thiamine, riboflavin, niacin, vitamin B12, and folic acid, as well as natural flavoring, which contains celery. Okay, so we're gonna have to break Her Majesty's seal right there. Sticky there. Let's get this open. I'll do a little lid sounds. See a little bit right there. There is no paper covering, so the seal is the only thing that you have to go by to let you know that it's fresh or unopened. Some of the Marmite on the lid makes it a little difficult to make a lot of lid sounds. Oh, I forgot to, one more thing. Real quick, forgot all about chicken finger. Usually I'm chicken finger with me everywhere I go. Oh, there it is. Just a second. Okay. All right, a little chicken finger first. Thank you, chicken finger. Let's see what this smells like. Yeah, I am picking up an aroma of beer, which makes sense. So that's hitting me right away. Just a classic, you know, that beer aroma. Almost like molasses as well. Kind of like soy sauce too, a little bit. All right. Apparently the nutritional information is underneath here. Says the nutritional information is inside sticker, but I'm having a hard time in getting it. Looks like it's just thin to be able to open it up. Strange. Usually you can tell it's like a little booklet, but this doesn't look like that. It looks like one solid piece. It doesn't look like anything I can open, so I can't really make out. You can see, I'm not sure if you can tell, you can see it's printed. I'm trying to see what the sodium, oh man, I can't really see. So, alright, that's really strange. Usually some of these are like little booklets. You can just open them right up, but this is, it's not the case. If I tear it. I still can't get to. That's weird. Okay. Well, looks like the nutritional information is going to be a mystery. Actually, let's take a look online here. Okay, so we have, I'm really concerned about the fat, very small, but we have 6 grams of salt per 8 gram serving. All right, well, we better get moving here. Before everything gets cold, let's pour this tea. This is still, fortunately, still nice and, it's not super hot, but there's a little bit of steam coming off, so that's fine. So it's not hot, but it's definitely warm, warmer than lukewarm. So let's get some of this out. Marmite. So here you can see. It's got a very molasses-like texture. So look at that. So let's just take a little taste of that. Okay, here we go. Wish me luck. That is just I rarely ever make a face like this. Of all the eating videos I've done and the tasting videos, I need a little bit of this. Wow, how do I even begin to describe that? It's like very molasses. That kind of texture and consistency, but without any kind of sweetness. Very salty. Like, have you ever had sardines like that? I don't know what else. That kind of really strong saltiness. Just very, very powerful. That was a little bit too much. I didn't think it was going to be that strong. Wow. Okay. A bitter or tart? I guess bitter. Okay, but I said I would try in the tea. So let's get a little bit of this. See if we can get it to melt in the. Probably should have been much hotter. There we go. There we go, it's getting there. I've already had my fill of this. I really don't feel like torturing myself anymore, but here we go. Marmite tea. Probably just a teaspoon of Marmite, maybe less. Okay. Oh man, it's just that strong. Potent. It's almost like, I don't know, it's almost like the au jus you would get, like a beef broth, but this is stronger than beef broth. Now, having it in the tea, it's not that bad. This is actually all right. It has a really pungent odor, though, to it. Because of the warmth and all that, I guess. You know what? It's almost like beef broth or chicken broth. It's just a warm liquid, very salty. So that's not bad. But eating it raw, right off of the, out of the jar, oh man, that was tough. That was tough. Okay. All right, so we're going to try a little bit on the, let's do the toast first. So, do a little bit like that. Stuff is going to put some hair. I don't know. Wherever I don't have hair. The back of my calves. My feet. My face. I'll probably have hair growing like just out of my face. After this. Okay. My hands. It's going to turn me into like a werewolf. Alright, so I have some buttered toast. Of course, it's been cold. It's cold down right now. It's hard to time everything, but let's get some of this Marmite onto the toast. Oh man, why am I doing this? Okay, it's really hard to spread. Of course, it's not as, and I don't even really, I'm already regretting wanting to taste it, but let's just spread it out like that. All right, since I don't have cheese and crackers, oh man, here we go. Salty. Man, there is a ton of salt. Now, having it on the toast with a little bit of butter, it's not too bad. It's definitely an acquired taste. I don't think it's going to be a taste that I plan on acquiring. Let me just wash it down with some Marmite tea. Yay. Oh, man. You know, you want to torture somebody and get some information out of them? Marmite. Seriously. That's all I need to say. All right. Okay. Let's do the last bit. We'll finish up. A little Marmite, some graham cracker. Let's get some more of this stuff. Man, this is like one of the only foods besides mayonnaise. Mayonnaise, I can't even get into my, past my nose. Mayonnaise and cream cheese, I really don't like the sour foods unless they're mixed with something, you know, and you can't really, you don't really notice the sourness, but, all right, this is it, folks. This is the last one. Marmite on some graham cracker. I'm thinking this might taste okay. It's really, it's like spreading molasses. Look at this stuff. Okay. Down the hatch. Now, let me just wash that down with a little bit of Marmite tea. Now, I don't know about anyone outside the United States, but here in the U.S., a nice, tasty little snack or treat is to put some butter on the graham cracker, because you get a little bit of salty, you know, the butter flavor with some of the sweetness of the graham cracker, and that's really good. This, not quite the same. You get that salty, the salt sweet, but the even this little amount of Marmite, it very overpowering of the graham cracker. So Not the best combination. So, all right. I don't even want to finish that little bit. Okay. Well, I had to try it to see what this was all about. Yeah, unfortunately, this is going to be pretty much a waste. I will not be eating this ever again. It's too salty. And it's real strong. And, I mean, I don't know. I hope I'm not offending any Marmites out there. But, yeah. Okay, so, you know, I'll try almost anything. So, if Vegemite is the same, then I'm not going to try that either. Alright. So that's that. Not liking it at all. Sorry. But I hope you enjoyed this. And hey, if you're feeling a little, you know, daring, go ahead and pick up some Marmite. But don't say I didn't warn you. Alright, so thanks for tuning in. And I think that'll do it. We'll just end on some chicken finger versus Marmite. And until next time, take care of yourself and hope to see you in another video or podcast real soon. So long for now.